Hello students, welcome again. In this session I am going to discuss about the chapter 10 respiration organisms.
Chapter 10.
This is the second part of this series. In first part I discussed about the meaning of respiration and types of respiration, that is aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration, and breathing also. Breathing is a part of respiration. Breathing involves just inhaling of oxygen rich air into our lungs and exhaling of carbon dioxide rich air into the atmosphere, and one inhalation and one exhalation together makes a one breath, and the number of breaths we take for 1 minute is known as a breathing rate. So that's very simple. Now how do we breathe? So the different parts of a human body which is involved in the breathing procedure are pointed out here, and you can see a picture of a human respiratory organs in chapter number 112. There you can observe different parts which are in a respiratory system, that is a nasal passage or a nasal cavity, you can say. Then oral cavity, pharynx is the point where nasal cavity and oral cavity are joined together, and trachea is another name for a windpipe, and trachea is splits into different many branches into the lungs, and lungs is protected by a rib cage. Okay, rib cage or ribs, these are the bones, and there is a muscular layer between lungs and a digestive system, that is known as diaphragm is a muscular layer that separates the respiratory system and the digestive system, right? So what is the function of the rib cage? Rib cage protects the lungs from any injury from the outside, and the diaphragm separates. So when we are inhaling oxygen or while inhaling, what happens? The rib cage moves outwards and the diaphragm moves downwards to make a space for the lungs. While exhaling, what happens? Rib cage move backwards, whereas diaphragm move upwards to contract the lungs. This procedure continuously repeats. This is the way how we breathe in or breathe out. Next, what do we breathe in or what do we breathe out? Actually, the air what we breathe in contains only 21% of oxygen, and out of the 21, hardly 4.6% is utilized by the body. Remaining 16.4% is exhaled. Okay, exhaled, and 4.4% of carbon dioxide is removed. Approximately 4.4% of carbon is removed in the body during exhalation. Okay. So this is the way how we humans breathe. Similarly, all mammals breathe in a similar fashion, but in few other animals it is different. So breathing in other animals such as for example, let's take cockroach. The breathing system in a cockroach is discussed here. Cockroaches has many small openings at its sides, and they are known as spiracles, and every spiracle is connected to a tube which passes through the inside the cockroach's body, which exchanges the air directly with the tissue, and the tubes are known as a trachea. And the many grasshoppers have a similar type of a breathing system. Second one is the earthworm. Earthworm directly breathe through its moist and slimy skin directly. Then how few aquatic animals breathe inside water? Few aquatic animals breathe inside water, especially the breathing system of fish is discussed here. Fish, we all know that fish, the respiratory organ of fish is a gills, not lungs. Okay, gills absorb the oxygen which is present in the water, and fish using that oxygen does the same aerobic respiration, right? Gills are the projections. Gills are the projections of the skin. Okay. Next. So one question I ask us, whether plants also respire? Yes, plants also respire. Photosynthesis is a different phenomena. Photosynthesis takes place when the sunlight is present. It is a production of a food. Okay, food is produced by the with the help of sunlight and carbon dioxide. In that case, oxygen is exhaled, oxygen is released. But plants also respire to utilize the energy, to utilize the food which they have prepared for other production of leaf, production of flowers, for other maintenance of the trees. They have to utilize the food which they have prepared. In that case, plants is also need to be respire. In that case, plants also take oxygen and does an aerobic respiration. In that case, what happens? Every part of the plant is independent. The leaves are independent. They are not dependent on one another. And roots of the plants also respire by taking oxygen which is present inside the soil. Air gaps, air spaces. Roots absorb oxygen from the air spaces which is present in the soil. By this way, we have observed that respiration is a very important process in our life, and breathing is just a part of the respiration. Okay, so I already provided notes for all these the questions of the chapter number 10. You can write all the answers in a classwork. In the next session, I am going to start chapter number 11. Transportation in animals and plants. Till then, you can complete your notes. You can get your fare signed by coming to the school in between 1:30 to 3:30. Okay. Thank you, one and all. Have a nice day. Bye.